Hi, Mark here from Car Questions. Just an update on the Toyota recall investigation. Let's have a look at the evidence so far. Number one, we've got major news organizations reporting the complaint. We've got Toyota admits a problem, but they're minimizing it, saying it happens in rare instances. And they're erring on the side of caution. It's exactly what you expect them to do. So that evidence in totality is simply we know there's a complaint and the company admits to it. There have been no verified publicly available complaints, no verified publicly available witness statements. That's true, and that's telling. And then we have no verified faulty parts publicly available. No pictures, no videos. Now, that's significant. Sometimes evidence or a lack of evidence is evidence itself. If you use logic and reason, and we use science, statistics would tell us that Toyota has a 10% market share at a minimum for the last few years. This recall involves around 4 million cars, so if you put the two recalls together, the floor mat and the accelerator pedal. Taking that into consideration, and the fact that a major news organization like CBS has 32,000 employees, statistically, that would mean that it's probable, that their employees drive Toyotas, and that there's hundreds of Toyotas as close as the nearest company parking lot. Which means all you'd have to do is go outside and get a car and film one, find one out of the hundreds that they have available to them and show it to everybody. That's not happening. And that is significant. Again, a lack of evidence is sometimes evidence itself. If you look at the world we live in the YouTube world, like what we're doing right now, anybody has a cell phone or video camera handy, and in seconds, every time there's an earthquake or a schoolyard fight, we've got video of it. Millions of cars, no video. That's very telling. Where is this evidence? Somebody, somewhere, should be posting a picture of a faulty part or showing one of these cars accelerating. It would be easy. Statistically speaking, they should be able to be found. We all know people who drive Toyotas. Show me the car. This story is sounding a lot like a story that was run by CBS back in November 1986 in the Audi 5000. Lots of complaints about unintended acceleration. Yes, deaths were linked to that. All the people were going to sue. Similar story being told now. Except when they did, they all lost. CBS couldn't find a car at the time to do what these people were saying it did. They looked, couldn't find one. So they contacted an advocacy group who, yes, did have one of these cars that they could film because it makes good TV to show what you're talking about. Especially in today's world, that's more true than ever. Well, they did. Turns out years later, after some good investigation techniques using science and rational thought and logic, they find out that car was rigged. CBS doesn't brag about that anymore, by the way. But you gotta wonder today why they don't have any pictures or video of this. They do like the publicity it generates, and I'm sure they like the revenue. But a good statistic you can see. If that many cars, 10% of the cars on the road today are Toyotas, and 4 million of those have problems, we would be able to get one of these cars, and we can't. At least not yet. Let's hope somebody can post a picture or post some evidence showing a stuck pedal, showing one of these cars accelerating wildly, like is being claimed. And CBS, NBC, and ABC, and AP, and all the rest, stop reporting all the fear and start reporting some evidence. Because from where I'm sitting, you're not doing that. Thanks again for watching.